Hello everyone, this is Akang Suman here. We are going to discuss simple mechanisms, the first chapter of the theory of machine. In the simple mechanisms, we will discuss kinematic links or kinematic element. First, I am going to tell you what is the importance of simple mechanisms in the examinations. If you are preparing for the GATE exam, or engineering service examination or state PSC examinations. In all the examinations, you will see the questions from the simple mechanisms. Okay. If I'm talking about the GATE examinations, there will be the numerical types question generally they ask. Okay. It may be 1 marks question, it may be 2 marks question. But in the engineering service examinations, since each questions contain 1 marks, so basically you can see the number of questions 1, 2, 3. Okay, it may be like that. In the state PSC examinations, of course, there will be the questions from the simple mechanisms. When we will study the whole chapters, I will let you know what types of questions is going to be asked from the simple mechanisms. Okay, so in the simple mechanisms, there is a kinematic links or element. First, we need to understand what is the difference between the link and the kinematic link. Okay, see this diagram. This is the first diagram. Okay. When I separate all the links and I consider it individually, there will be the 4 links. Okay, individually they will considered as link only. Individually they will considered as link. We cannot say this is the kinematic link. We generally say this is link. Okay, and this is link. So what is the basic criteria for the link to be considered as kinematic link is that when one link is in relative motions with respect to other links, then we can say this would be the kinematic links. So in this diagram, you can see that link 1 and link 2 are in relative motion with respect to each other. Link 2 and the link 3 are in relative motion with each other. Link 3 and link 4 are in relative motions with each other. So that is the basic criteria. First basic criteria for the kinematic links is that they are having some relative motions. Okay. If you are going to consider another example, you can see in the machine there are a number of components. Okay, so some of the parts of the machine are in relative motion with respect to some other parts of the machine elements. So that is why we can say they are the kinematic links, because they are having some relative motions. So this is the first criteria for the link to be considered as kinematic link. If I'm talking about the second criteria is that the link should be resistant body. What it is? The link should be resistant body. You must have to remember these two conditions. This is first and the second condition. Okay. The link should be resistant body. What is the meaning of the resistant body? See this diagram. This is second diagram. You have to see. This is the slider and this is connecting rod and this is crank which is going to be rotating. Okay. Now, we want the slider to reciprocate only. We want the slider to translate only. We don't want slider to rotate or revolution. Okay. So basically, slider is resistant to rotation, slider is resistant to revolution in any other motion. Okay, slider is just to want to reciprocate. So that means that is the resistant body. Okay, so what is the crank motion? Crank is only for rotation. Okay, we don't want crank to be reciprocate. Okay, so basically crank is resistant to reciprocation. So that is the meaning of the resistant body. Okay. Whatever be the motion we define for any component, the motion should be only that. Okay, there will not be any other motion for the crank and the slider that we don't define. So basically in the examination, they generally ask what is the criteria for the kinematic links or elements. So you must have to remember two things. The first is they are having some relative motions, and the second thing, the link should be resistant body. If I'm talking about the engineering service examinations, generally they contain multiple choice questions. You can get one or both the statements there. So if there is both the statement, there will all the statement would be correct. Both the statement would be correct. So I hope you will get the understanding of the kinematic links or element.